Hello and good evening. I am Donia Elizabeth from Aircruise Aviations Private Limited. Here I am going to give a small presentation on how to make your day super productive. So there is a quote by Paul J. Mayer who said, "Productivity is never an accident. It is the result of a commitment to excellence, intelligent planning, and forecasted efforts." This presentation will take you through a few methods or some routine that can be inculcated into your daily lifestyle, which will help in increasing your productivity and making you achieve more in a particular day. So I'll just share my screen now with the presentation. So the first point is to prepare your outfit the night before. So every day when you wake up, you spend maybe 10 to 15 minutes on just picking out what is the outfit for the day. But if this is done the previous day, the morning hours, which is more productive, will be used on better efficient decisions and better work. So here, it makes you reduce time on unnecessary decisions. And if you look at very successful people like Barack Obama and Mark Zuckerberg, we can see that they wear the same clothes every day because they're eliminating that unnecessary decision process. Then you need to plan your day also the night before. So here, what happens is... if you actually have a plan of what the schedule is for that particular day, jotted down the day before, then it will be easier for you to like have an idea about what is it that you have to do, and you will have a clearer picture on what you have to spend your time. It will also be a lot more easier if you have a week's plan mapped out, so it will take much lesser time to plan the day. Then you should also have a master to-do list. So here, usually what people normally do is every day when they get to their office, they create a to-do list for that particular day. But a master to-do list will contain all the tasks that have to be done along with the date, and you can keep on updating it and eliminates the process of creating multiple to-do lists, and that makes it easier to track. And this method is more organized. The main factor here is that you should always keep it updated. Then we can use the ABCDE method. This method includes categorizing whatever is the task that you have identified into 5 categories, wherein A is the one with the highest priority. And these tasks, if are not done, will actually create a lot of issues. And then B is a medium priority task. C will be the lowest priority. So you will try to get this done in that particular day, but even if you don't get it done, it will not have any repercussions. And D category will be tasks which you are delegating to your subordinates, and E tasks are the ones which you eliminate. That is, these are tasks that you do not need to do. Here we use the 80-20 principle, which shows that 20% of your task actually contributes to 80% of the total productivity. Then once you've categorized your task, you need to set timelines to get these things done. So here, once the tasks are mapped out, you need to identify how much time would be required for a particular task. This will make sure that all the tasks will have ample time, and you will get all these things done properly and in a systematic manner. So if you look at how Bill Gates plans his time, he has every minute planned meticulously, and for all tasks, there will be fixed time slots, and this will avoid any sort of distractions, and it makes him stay goal-driven, which is another factor of a successful person. And another important thing is getting up 2 hours early. So here, you will get 2 extra hours in your day, and these morning hours usually are very productive for almost a lot of people. So here, if you take examples of Mary Barra of General Motors and Pepsi's ex-CEO Indira Nooyi, they wake up before or with the sun, and this they admit that it will help them get a head start before the other world gets out of bed and starts working. Then another thing that you can do is meditate for 5 minutes. So this will help in relaxing your body and mind. And once your body and mind is relaxed, it improves focus and it improves productivity. So if you look at Oprah's daily routine, she starts with a 20-minute meditation session for keeping her mind at peace. That makes you be better productive throughout the day. Then an important task that is eating your breakfast, which many people tend to miss. This is because breakfast is the first meal of the day. And here, breakfast becomes your body's fuel. So if your body does not get its fuel, it's not going to function properly. So having a proper and a healthy breakfast will boost your brain power, and thus it will increase your productivity for that day. Then another one is setting up a specific time to check emails. A lot of people usually spend a lot of time in checking emails all the time. So here, either you can set up particular times, like depending on what is the frequency of emails that you get, maybe two or three minute slots in 4 hours or 3 hours, depending on your frequency of emails that you receive. You can keep checking your mails and use the 2 minute rule to just skim through your email inbox and identify what is the urgent and priority ones and so on. If you look at Elon Musk, he will check his mail in the morning. He will skim through his emails. He will just skim through his emails in the morning, and he has fixed timelines for it. So this is because you will eliminate all the time wasted constantly rechecking your emails. Then once you reach the office and you start working, it's important that you keep yourself unreachable when you're doing a high priority task. So here, if you isolate yourself from any gossips or vacation plans that are being talked about by your colleagues, here what happens is you will get a continuity, and it will improve your it'll improve your focus and helps you to have better control of your task. And it also leads to less distractions. So if you look at how Elon Musk takes up his activities in a day, he does not take phone calls because that will cause distractions to the work he is doing, and he only reaches out to people through emails. Now, another important thing is don't do so many meetings in a day. So if you cramp up a lot of meetings in a day, what happens is you will the implementation time would be very less, as well as you get drained off and you become unproductive. So all the meetings towards the end would be very unproductive. So it is also a fact that in a lot of Fortune 500 companies, consultants have actually told them that they have to reduce the number of meetings that they have. And usually they do it standing up so that meetings are better productive, and it will be always to the point and there will not be a lot of time wastage. Then another one is learning to say no. So if you get unreasonable requests, you are supposed to say no, because this if you keep on saying yes for all requests that you get, you will lose the time to focus on the more productive works. So here, it is also said that a successful and super productive person's very important skill should be to say no. A quote by Steve Jobs says that he's actually proud of the things that he hasn't done, as the things that he has done, because here he mentions that innovation is saying no to 1,000 things. Then another one is workout. So every time you move on with all your work related activities, you need to make sure that your body stays healthy, because then only it will also help you back in making your day productive. So here, maintaining a healthy lifestyle is very important, and it is ideal to have at least 2 workout sessions in a week at the minimum. So if you look at Elon Musk, he also does not take his health lightly. To stay in shape, he makes sure that he has at least twice a week where he hits the gym. Then another thing is drink more water and stay hydrated. This is also a part of a healthy lifestyle. So the fact less known is that a dehydrated body means very less energy to perform any task. Your brain drains out a lot. So these less energy that you have in your body will obviously transfer to less productivity. So it is very important that you stay hydrated. Then another thing that you can do is creating a trash and a stop doing list. So a stop doing list is something wherein you jot down all the things that you are not going to do. So if you look at the example, the list says that that the person is going to stop attending Chamber of Commerce meetings. And the reasons also have been listed down along with the time savings. Like what is the saving that they're doing because of not doing the particular task. And a trash list would be, so when you're doing some task and things pop up in your mind, you have to jot it down into another paper so that you can take care of it later on. And it is out of your mind at that particular point of time. So this eliminates any unnecessary time wastage activities or any unnecessary thoughts that would mean that your productivity reduces in a particular day. Then another important thing is getting things right the first time. So when you're doing a task, you should make sure that you put in all your effort to get it right the first time. Because here, as John Wooden has said, if you don't have the time to do it right, when will you have time to do it over? So it is exactly what is happening here. If you want your day to be productive, try maximum to get the things done at the first time, because here it would mean that there is less time wasted, less effort wasted, because you do not have to do it again. Then another thing is hiding distracting apps. So if you find yourself in a very important task, but you keep on moving to any apps like social media or any gaming apps, you need to make sure that before you start the work, all those apps are hidden or deleted or whatever suits you, because this will make sure that your flow is not hampered, and it will also make sure that no time is wasted in unproductive works. And it is also a fact that according to studies, social media reduces your attention span by numbers, and it promotes herd thinking, and it also affects your innovation. Thank you. It's again Donya here.